Yeah, I know there's a door in front of us that
Yeah.
we need to go through. That's it.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to Friday night on Channel Rob Tui. Welcome to Unknown Whom. We are playing Unknown Whom, available at DM's Guild, and this is gonna be the last episode of this module. The players are about to finish up here, I believe. So let's do intros so everybody knows who everybody is. I'm, of course, Rob Tui, the Dungeon Master. And let's start with Galren introducing yourself.
So this is Mark or McClancy 10,006, as Rob likes to say, playing Galren the Bard.
All right, and Havoc.
Hi everyone, this is Havoc playing Havoc the Druid.
And Water. Push to talk.
Fuck, I forget this shit. I hate push to talk now. Okay, anyways, this is Fury Fate playing a water genasi. I am an artificer, pirate. I don't know my name, so we just keep calling me Water. So, oh yeah, and I have a dog. His name is Chad. Please show off Chad. He's adorable. He needs some love.
Does Chad have a picture? I think he, no, I guess
Yeah, yes, he does.
he doesn't. Not in the
Just zoom
stat
in on
block.
it. Oh, just zoom in on the token. It's a cute little dog. He's metal, made out of metal.
He's got a little blood on his face right now.
Holy
It's okay.
Testicle
It's okay.
Tuesday.
Thank you for the resub 52 months in a row. That's got to be some kind of record, 52 months. Thank you, sir. McClancy. Right, so the players are here. Just a little programming note for those watching here at the beginning. We will be playing today, and then this game, the Friday night game, will be on a hiatus until February 18th. We're gonna be taking I guess it turns out a couple months off. And then when we come back, Furied will DM Unknown Whom Part 2, and then when she wraps that up, we'll move on to an yet undetermined campaign as DM'd by Mark. So that'll be
Gonna
fun.
involve hunting dragons.
It's gonna involve hunting dragons, especially the one that's behind him
Not
right now.
Strixhaven, where we go to school and we learn about ourselves and we do jobs and careers. I really
No,
want to
and my
play that
dragons are
one.
going to have alignment.
We'll leave that to you to
What?
run. Oh no, alignment dragons. All right, so you guys, as a recap here, you guys entered this room. There was a large reflecting pool sitting here in two columns, a sarcophagus that stands in the northwest corner. And there is a door. I kind of made a little blue arrow there because there's a condition of the module that states the door isn't there unless you guys did something previously, which you did. So there is a door. It's not hidden. There is just a door there.
What was the condition?
That you run into the big green eye. If
Did we
you,
do that?
yeah, remember the pentagram room? And he was in there. You went up on the pulpit and read the book, remember?
Oh, yeah. Now I remember.
That's
It's been a while. It's been like what, 2, 3 weeks? I don't remember all
Yeah,
this
for the
shit.
stream, what I'm talking about for the stream is this room here. This room here is where they were. I
So that
can't
was like what, one episode, 2 episodes behind.
well, I
They
can't
can
remember. I
rewatch.
don't know what the hell happened. Oh, I just erased all the whatever, that's fine. Okay, so what do you guys want to do? What do you guys do? Oh, and Fury, you can give yourself inspiration if you want.
But we came in from the door that's shown, right?
Yeah, you came in here, right?
We should go north.
Yeah.
I mean, might as well. It's the only door, and I don't think this reflective pool did anything for us. Did we touch the reflective pool?
No, I don't think you did. You looked in it.
Okay, did we touch the sarcophagus?
No.
Well, Havoc, Galren, y'all want to touch the water? Y'all want to touch the sarcophagus?
I don't want to touch nothing.
We've tried this before. It
I
goes
don't want to touch
badly.
nothing.
All right. Water will touch the water in the reflective pool.
Okay, you reach your hand out and you timidly touch the water like something's gonna bite you or attack you, and nothing happens.
Oh, boo. Wait. Because we've drank mysterious water before and the effects happened. She will take a sip of the water in the pool.
You cup your hand down there to get enough to take a sip and you drink it and it seems quite refreshing, but nothing noticeable happens to you.
Wow.
Boo.
Alright, let's kick the sarcophagus instead. Let's cause some other
Kick it over.
Hold on, let me move over.
Scaredy cat.
So if you now what do you mean? You're gonna kick it so that it falls down?
Well, don't they usually have a lid?
Yeah, but it's leaning up. So the map doesn't do it as much justice as, I mean, I made this map like 5 years ago, but it's supposed to be leaning up against the corner. So it's upright, you know,
definitely not how the map.
No,
okay.
But I mean, how would I have done that? I don't know how to do that. But it is sealed. You can definitely tell that it's got a lid that can be opened, but it might be, it might be, you have to make a check to see if you can open it or whatever.
Should we open it?
Yes, absolutely. Do it.
Okay, if you want to, McClance or Galrin, you can make a strength check to see if you can open it. If you had a crowbar, that would give you advantage on your check.
I'll give him guidance, too.
Okay, you can roll the so with guidance, a minimum of one, you would make it. So you open the sarcophagus, and inside, you see this. You see this, but it does not. It does not do anything. It's just inert.
It's got some shinies, but other than that, we should burn it. Burn it. Burn it. Do it.
You want to set the mummy on fire?
Hell yeah. I got a torch. I could just, stick it over there and light it on fire.
I'm going to back up.
Okay, well, if you want to try to torch it, you can totally do that.
I feel like it's a smart move here. When in doubt, just burn shit. Look at me with my little torchlight ring. I love it. Because I don't have dark vision.
Look at you. Oh, and here, if you, that's what she sees, everybody. I'm on the stream, I don't see your thing, but I can make it so they look like that. So each of the players see, each of the players see differently. But I see the whole thing. Okay. So you light up your torch and just touch it to the mummy. Is that what you would do?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. So you do that and it definitely does, let's see. All right, it definitely does damage to it, and then now you can all roll initiative.
Yay! Oh.
I forget, does Chad... Chad goes on your initiative, right?
Yeah, my
okay,
initiative.
Okay, so he's got skip turn in there. All right, so you guys all rolled initiative, and it all sucked really bad. So, this will be round one, actually. And... the mummy will act. And the mummy uses its dreadful glare. It will definitely target the person who just lit it on fire. Hello.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you fail your save, which means you are... frightened and paralyzed.
Oh, fuck. What can Chad do?
And then... let's see. Did that work? Paralyzed. And frightened. Yeah, and then it will also attack you with its rotting fist. And it will hit you doing 14 points of damage, making you do another save, which you succeed.
Oh, good.
Galren, your teammate is fucked up.
I'm going to move back there.
Wow.
And then I'm going to cast Cloud of Daggers on the mummy.
Okay, sharing is caring. Cloud of Daggers for me. I forget what that does. Oh, well, you could have used the little white thing in the top right, the top left of the... That's fine.
No, where, what?
On the spell itself, in the upper left, right next to the shield, is a little teeny white... Yeah, that. That's what I was trying to get you to do. So
I did not notice that level of detail.
That's an extension called Sharing is Caring, so we can all read it. Oh, snap. Okay, so you can do that, but then it doesn't move if it moves out of it. So it's basically going to do it one time unless he's stupid.
Yeah.
Look at that. Look at everybody. Look at the Cloud of Daggers. Look at it. Look at it. It's there. And I keep getting errors. I don't know what these errors are.
Yeah, I got a whole bunch of errors when I joined the table. I think something with the update.
It's vision stuff that somebody needs to do something about. We're just going to ignore it. It's not going to affect anything. All right, so you do that, and then that does damage at the beginning of his turn, so we'll keep that ready. Havoc, what do you do?
All right, I'm going to throw out my weapons and move to there.
Pin him in the cloud. That's what we got to do.
So I'm trying to get him.
You're able to draw one weapon.
Right. I'm going to pull out the first one and basically just smack at him.
Okay, go for it. That is a hit. You do damage to him, and you notice that it is resisted damage.
All right, and I'm going to go up. Like, I'm going to go for my second weapon, but I'm trying to, like, interpose myself between him and water. Or it and water. I don't know.
Okay. And did you not roll initiative, or you... Oh, you've got a fucking zero. Wow.
Yeah, I rolled.
No. Water. Waters.
He's talking about me.
Waters' initiative is literally zero. She rolled a one minus one. Wow.
So do you want to do a one and one for me and Chad? I mean, it doesn't really matter.
No. I just. You, when I see a zero, I always assume that the person didn't roll, but I looked and you did roll. Zero's sadly. Fine. Negative one's fine. Whatever we have to.
Okay.
Have.
So water can't move because she's paralyzed, right?
Yeah. Paralyzed not only means you can't move,
but can't attack.
You're incapacitated. You're incapacitated as well, so can't take actions or reactions. Yeah, you can't do anything.
Yeah. All right, so Chad is going to be my defender, obviously, protect me. He's going to target the mummy. He is going to do a force-empowered rend. Okay, and I think that's all he can do right now. Too bad he can't attack twice. That'd be great.
Okay, so next up is Galren. And your Water's paralyzation and frighten will... well, she's no longer frightened, but the paralyzation will come off at the end of the mummy's turn.
Okay.
So, it's been a while since I've done this. I'm doing a concentration spell, but can I shoot a bow?
You can shoot a... Yeah, you can shoot a bow with a concentration spell, yeah. You just can't cast another concentration
spell. And then I'm... Through Havoc is a minus two or a minus five?
Minus two. And a 14 is a hit. You did not have him targeted.
I will fix that error.
All right, and you do a damage, which you also notice to be resisted.
All right, and then I'm going to dance my turn. I get to do the Cloud of Daggers damage.
Yes, you get to do that, exactly. And he also resists that. So he's a resister.
Did he resist any of the damage that Chad did? I'm sorry, I should have asked earlier.
No, he did not.
Oh, okay, cool.
Chad did force damage, which he took all of.
Cool, awesome.
All right, now the mummy is, of course, now going to decide what am I going to do by rolling a d6 to choose a target. And that target is, the target is water.
Okay, Chad will be posing a disadvantage on it with his deflect attack reaction. So, of course, the mummy will be attacking with a disadvantage.
Okay. First thing it's going to do is the dreadful gaze, which you succeed on.
Good.
And then
so I won't be useless.
Disadvantaged, which will probably be a regular attack because you are paralyzed. And he misses. And so, yes. And then now you are no longer paralyzed. And it is your turn.
Lovely. Okay.
He did not move out of the daggers because he dumb.
It's fine. Perfect for us. Okay. I'm going to let Chad go first and also do his same attack.
Okay. He does a force attack. Wait a minute.
Oh, sorry.
Oh.
Because I didn't target the...
I'll give you the 13.
The 13? Okay.
And that's a hit.
Okay, cool.
And he does five more. Oh, seven. He does seven more damage. Force damage.
And then she will do... she's going to cast Cure Wounds on herself.
Okay. Is the dog's thing... Wow. Is the dog's thing a bonus action for you? Is that what it is?
No, he has his own turn.
Oh, he does. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so you heal yourself a bit. And Havoc, it is you.
All right, so I'm going to attack first with the scimitar.
Miss...
And then with the short sword.
Hit. And he takes no damage from your 1 point of damage that you roll. Funny.
This is terrible.
That's terrible.
Don't you have like a second weapon? Can't you do a second attack?
Just did. I missed the first one.
Oh. Don't you have inspiration to re-roll?
Well, not he might have rerolls, but not on damage. Okay, Galren, it is you again.
Missed, and I didn't do the minus two, so I would have missed again.
So you really missed? Okay, cool. Havoc.
I'll just keep swinging at it.
Yep, that's a hit. Resisted. and another hit, and no damage. You're looking at your short sword and your offhand going, what the fuck is this piece of shit? It doesn't do anything. Okay, water.
Yeah, I guess I'll try to attack with a dagger melee attack.
Okay. Do you have two daggers?
Well, technically, yes.
You could pull out the other one and attack twice then. Because those are light weapons, right?
Right, but I'm also holding my torch.
Ah, but. Okay, never mind. I tried to get creative. So you attack with your dagger, and... hit is not pronounced it's pronounced... All right. Oh, and wait a minute. You have an infused dagger, which does full damage, and so you did 8 damage.
Yes. Yeah, I took some time to infuse my weapons because,
it's a magical dagger, right.
Mm-hmm. And all right, and the Chad is going to go bite.
Okay. Chad bite, and he does successfully bite and does 6 damage. So this mummy is bloodied.
Gonna now, dagger him.
He's going to... Oh, yep, he gets the daggers, right? Go ahead. And he is critically wounded, but he is going to make an attempt against Havoc. So I will change targets and roll my stuff.
Well, which Chad will oppose disadvantage.
Oh, okay. So Havoc succeeds on the Dreadful Glare, and then he's going to have disadvantage. He can do that every turn?
He can do it as a reaction.
Wow.
Every turn.
What the fuck? Okay, here we go. So disadvantage, and it is a miss. So the mummy is fucked. And Havoc gets to go first.
It's nice having a defender around, right?
It is.
Kind of like it.
Havoc hits the mummy and does some damage. That mummy's hurting. And he does hit. Oh, he finally does 1 point of damage with his offhand weapon. And Galren.
Kill this thing.
I'm going to try the bow again. I did the minus 2 this time, like I'm supposed to.
And you fumbled. And we are, as a reminder to those watching, we are not using the fumble tables in this particular module because it's honed for certain things, so we don't want to fuck with that too much. Water, you are up.
Okay, again with the infused dagger. Oh no.
That is a miss.
All right, Chad, fix this for me.
Chad's attack is a hit and does 6 damage, and the mummy is done.
Not undead, it's re-dead.
The dishes are done, man. Yeah, it's re-dead.
Look at all those little skulls on there. It's great. The little skull and crossbone stacking on top of each other.
Right.
And I'm going to go retrieve some arrows.
All right, and then you can do that, and the mummy will go away. And all that is waiting for you is the door on the north side of the room. Which, assuming you guys open, I will show you because I don't know that you guys
could
have clicked on that. And you see that, here, let me describe this blue floor here, this area. As you go look into that room, it is a long hallway that has an ice floor. And the walls are also ice, and even the ceiling is frozen. The cold is extreme. But that's all you know so far.
think we should blindly go down the tunnel and see what happens.
I agree. Except because it's icy, I think we should just skate
half
down
movement,
that tunnel.
Half movement.
Skate down the tunnel.
Let's see, I'm trying to remember here. I've unlocked your tokens now.
Cool.
So as you guys move through that ice, you will notice that much like the slippery, slimy green floor you had before, if you try to move more than 10 feet at once, you have to make a check to see if you fall. So while the tokens are unlocked, I'm not going to worry about that too much, but just to let you know that you guys in your head, you have that information, like if something were to appear and you had to run or whatever, you've got that situation going.
So since we're not in that scenario, I'm going to bardically inspire water.
Yeah, you can do that. That lasts 10 minutes.
She's going to be risky. She's going to move faster than she should. She's going to embrace the slippery floor and go sliding around. And Chad will, you know, try to keep up with her.
Okay. And as long as you're not fighting any monsters, you know if you fall you can just get back up, right? So it's not a big deal at this point. But are there going to be monsters? You don't know. Chad,
he's got dark vision, he's so good. I think everybody needs a Chad in their life. Oh my god, this hallway.
Everyone needs a Chad. Okay, stop. Nobody move. No, you go move Chad back where he was when I said the word stop.
Okay, but water would be right behind him.
Right,
but
that's not how it happened, so we're not going to do it.
Well, I can't move two tokens at the same time, Robert.
Exactly. No, you're going to be back here.
No, they would be, then Chad wouldn't move. I'm telling you, they move together. I can't drag two tokens at once.
Okay, I'll give you that.
Thank you.
But you can.
I don't know how.
Yes, and in the future, which by the way,
forget.
You can actually.
How do you drag two tokens at once?
You go to. Can you, as a player, draw a box around two tokens?
Yeah, that's how I used to move me and my mini-me.
Yeah, and then you basically you're doing a group move.
How do you draw a box? Like, every time I tried to do, like, a drag and draw, it just moves the fucking map.
So if you do the selection mode on the top, you get that box with the circle, you can select the tokens.
Target mode.
Oh, yeah.
Is that how that's done? Hold on. Let me see if I can move them together. Oh, why didn't you guys tell me this before?
Never came.
Why didn't y'all let me do this for so long? So rude. So fucking rude.
We're holding on to our secrets. That's what's happening.
Hateful.
I see polar bears in the combat tracker. That's probably bad.
Yeah, so the thing is, I guess with line of sight. Well, that's a shame. My hesitation and my stumbling in my voice is I did not think this was a thing until I noticed it now. So here's what we're going to do. I don't know how to, I can't remember how to remove shit.
Remove what?
I just need to remove part of the wall. So there's a polar. So to the north, directly to the north and directly to the south of Fury's two characters are bars in the wall, and there's polar bears in these cages. But the person that did the line of sight just put walls there. And so I didn't notice that. I mean, I never thought to even look at it previously, right? I just didn't even think of that. So all I need to really do is take out those two wall segments, but I don't remember how to do that. I'm
feathering cages. Why did we not hear the polar bears when we were going down this hallway?
They were quiet. They were waiting.
Most quiet polar bears ever.
So does anybody know how to take a wall segment out? I just don't remember how to do it.
Yeah, I think you're supposed to go in the select mode and you click on the thing and just delete.
Oh shit. Okay. Well, I took out two, but that's okay. So now can you see the one below?
Yeah, I can see them both now.
Okay, all right. So, as you guys get there, these things attack you, obviously.
From the cages?
Yes, they reach out with their claws.
Oh.
And the...
Do we have a chance to dodge?
I mean, if you have a reaction that lets you do that. It's just like a normal attack. You're going to be in initiative now, only they surprised you. So they get a free shot.
Chad is vigilant, so he can't be surprised.
Okay. So just you get the attack.
And we will be posing disadvantage. But it's fine.
He missed anyway. I do not like this defender as a DM. I do not like it. I hate it. I can't wait to play it myself. So now everybody rolls initiative.
What are you talking about? As soon as you start the game, Chad's going to be covered in rust and he's going to fall apart. Oh no.
What? That happens now. That happens now.
It's too late.
Okay. So actually, Water, you are first. Now, these polar bears, the cages don't open. There's still bars there. So, you know, I'm just giving you that information. They don't, the bars don't open for them to come out. They're still just in there.
We could conceivably run past them, eh?
That's what I'm doing. I'm disengaging as my action and then moving my ass along with Chad, which I don't know why he didn't come with me. Because we work together. We're a group. We're a team.
Okay.
Chad's in front, obviously. Oh, yeah, polar bear. So Galarin and Havoc know.
So polar bear does nothing because it can't really attack at that point. So Galarin is next.
We have an interesting choice. I could Cloud of Dagger one of the polar bears. And it's in a cage and it can't get out.
Wow, that's fucked up. Where's PETA? Where's the animal protection people?
PETA's not worried about a polar bear trying to maul you guys.
The animals?
They're endangered.
Let's think about that. So I will take the dodge act.
Well, you can't.
Why not the disengage?
You can't really see the polar bears from where you are now. You have to kind of be direct.
But Water did yell out polar bears.
Right. No, you know they're there. It's just that you can't cast a spell on them because you can't see them.
They didn't cast a spell on them.
No, but, oh, so you're just going to stand there and dodge? Yeah, okay, that's fine. Are you going to do anything yet?
And then tokens aren't locked, but I'm going to move past them.
Oh, you're dodging and moving. I see. Okay, so then he will try to strike you. Interesting. Yeah, I might have done that differently. I see what you're going for. And he does miss. So
didn't
you
have disengaged and move?
That's what I would have done, because then there would have been no attack at all.
Yeah.
Oh, but I didn't see them, so I dodged and moved, and it worked out. I didn't die. So I can see them, but I can't see them from here?
So the line of sight would be, they're in cages, so here, let me...
Line of sight's a little broken right now.
No. Line of sight, you can't... So when I say line of sight, I'm not talking about Fantasy Grounds' physical line of sight map. I'm talking about you, the character, being able to see them. So two different things. And...
Okay, so but for Cloud of Daggers, it's a it's a point you choose within range. It doesn't say you have to see it.
Oh. Well, okay. But you've already dodged, so you're done.
Yeah, I can do it next turn, though.
Right. Except that if Havoc manages to get past the bears, you just walk out the end of the hall and be done with it. By the way, no, you guys are the first party. I've run this maybe 5 times. Many, you know, all of them in 2016 and 2017, but no party has ever figured out, oh, just disengage and run past them. Nobody, no party's ever figured that out. So what's happening?
Well, that's as far as I can move without falling down, so.
Risk it, fall and slide.
You
like a penguin, just like
yeah, but are
run
you...
and slide on your stomach.
Oh, can I turn into a penguin?
You are a druid. You could.
Yeah, that's their food. I'm not doing that.
And seals, I think. I don't know. What do...
They
no,
see
because...
a penguin, they're going to break open those bars and come out of there.
That is so not true, because polar bears live in the north and penguins are in the south. They don't mix.
All I do
but
is, all
on the
I know
Coke
is I want
commercial,
to get a...
they're all together. What's going on?
I want to get a good look at these polar bears, though, because I'm probably going to add them to my list of things I can turn into.
Do you have to, like, touch them, or is it just a visual thing?
I just got to see them.
Yeah, and most sure? Most DMs don't even, like, you can just turn into everything. It's, I don't know. I suppose if you were doing a hardcore campaign, it might be fun to restrict druids to only things they've seen. But I don't worry about it. All right.
Make
so,
it even harder. You have to touch it to get that DNA to turn into it.
Are you going to do anything else besides move 10 feet, Havoc?
No. Like, once I get to there, I'm going to get myself ready, and then I'm going to dash across and kind of, like, drop to my knees and slide to the other side.
Okay. And when you do that, will you be disengaging or not disengaging?
Yes. Disengaging. So
okay. So then... Based on that information, we can just simply end this here, because the end of the thing is at the end of the hall. You guys get out, and the polar bear wouldn't be able to attack you if you disengage, so you're basically out. So, boo, I didn't get another chance to kill you. All right. So now what happens is this.
Level up.
No, you guys are level 3 already. I need to... I'm going to exit the Friday game and go to private chat and pull Fearied in there with me and talk to her about shit that Havoc and Mark can't know. So...
Whoa.
Why?
Just you'll find out. So don't watch if Havoc and Mark have the stream up, I will count on you to either mute it or turn it off or whatever, but don't listen to this. I suppose because the people watching will get to know, but Havoc and Mark won't get to know.
So ooh, secret.
Here we go.
Alright, minimize the stream.
Alright, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay.
Hello.
So here's what happens. In this game, you know, the unknown whom is fucking with the party all the time. Turns out that's you. So now you get to, let's see. One player emerges as the villain. The player ends up the villain, won't know they're the villain until now, playing the bad guy. When the reveal comes, one character, So everybody,
Wait, well, how did we decide it was me?
I decided. The DM decides.
Okay.
And I just decided it would be fun to have you do it. That's just how I decided.
Because I have the defender?
Yeah, that's right. But,
oh, they're going to die.
So no. So here's what happens. So
I think I'll kill them.
The final encounter is, so here, I'll read it to you because you get to know everything anyway. So, the villain, the final map is just a white expanse that's like 300 feet. So you'll teleport 150 feet away from them, and you will have command of 3 waves of gnolls. And these gnolls will appear each round, you know, three, and then round two, another three, and then round three, another three. And and that's basically it. So they have a chance to kill you, or you have to kill all of them. That's pretty much it. Okay?
Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
So let's go back. Okay. So here we go. And we're back. All right. So let me push out this map. Oh, of course it's an error. What the fuck? Oh, okay. I guess it's not. Okay, here we go. So let me put you guys on it. One moment, please. Oh my God, these errors. Most of the errors are somehow it doesn't like, somehow it doesn't like the fact that it distinguishes NPCs between green, yellow, and red, and it always puts an error whenever you put something in the combat tracker. Anyway, okay, so okay, so just a minute, guys. I gotta set something up here. Let's see, this one. I'll push the map in a second as soon as I set it up. Okay, then I gotta get you guys over here. Of course, an error. And then oh, and so special condition for Furied Fate playing water, you notice that Chad is nowhere to be found.
No, not Chad. He's oh no.
Now let me say what's going on this map. You guys notice that you're in this white expanse. Now, why isn't there... There should have been a...
You know the polar bears are still on the combat tracker.
Oh, are they? Okay, thank you. I will get rid of them. I don't see them, actually. Oh, yeah, here we go. Okay, so you guys end up in this white expanse. And only now do you hear... I guess I just didn't write this part. I should have written this dialogue, but I guess I'll just make it up. I have seen you. I am going to be victorious. It is I that am the unknown whom, and you who must pay the price. And this is all coming out of Water's mouth. So basically the final
battle... My voice changed, apparently. My voice changed. Yeah.
Yeah. Basically, what it is the final battle is you two, Havoc and Galren against Water and her minions. And you notice that she does have minions that look like this.
Whoa.
And then for the Gnolls, Fury, you'll just tell me what you want me to do with them, and I'll. And here, let me let me share with you. Do you get this? Did you get a thing I sent you?
Yep.
Okay, so then you can tell me. I mean, you can control them, but I think I'd have to make them green for you to be able to control them, so you can just tell me what you want to do.
Okay.
Okay, so everybody can roll initiative.
So, do you need to change water to not green?
Oh, Yeah, yes, I do. So that'll be fun because that'll also be an error. But I let me know, Fury, if that does anything for you to not be able to control stuff.
Okay. I'm yellow right now. Do I need to be red?
Well, I think if I turn you red, you won't be able to control it.
Oh, try. Let's see. Do it. I can't move myself.
Okay, so let's put it back to let's put it that way.
Nope, can't do it when orange.
Okay, let's do it that way.
Orange, yeah, no. Turn it back to green.
Okay, so it's all green then. I'm glad I was able to cycle through all those because each time I did, I got an error in my fucking face. Okay. who has not rolled initiative?
Me.
Everyone's rolled except for the gnolls.
They've rolled.
Okay, that's fine. They all go before
me. So actually, okay, this is round one. And this is actually Galren is first. So Galren, who I believe has a bow.
I do. So the short range is 80, the long range is 320. Shoot like 200, I think. What happens? Do I have to adjust it or is it?
Yeah, it's just disadvantage. Oh, that's a hit. And right away, water takes 6 damage. Oh, and you see the weapons that the gnolls have, yeah? Fury?
Yeah, okay. I can see.
Okay. So next up is No small legs.
Okay. He is going to use his full movement to run up and also to kind of maybe go actually diagonal so where he's in front of me.
Okay. I'm going to get this auto center map off, man. That's crazy. Okay. So he's got a movement of, 30?
Mm-hmm.
So he's going to go... Whoops. Wait, what's the one that... Oh, there we go. He wants to come as much in front of you mean?
Yeah, make him go diagonally the whole 30 feet to where he's in front of me.
Okay, so he won't be able to make it all the way in front of you. He can get to there, is that okay?
I can't see where that is.
Oh,
so you're going to have to just get him.
30 foot of movement puts him there.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay.
He's going to use his own longbow and return fire to Galren.
Okay. So I'm just going to do a little experiment here. Yeah, awesome. That the extension is in there that knows ranges. So it
that doesn't make because it's 200 feet.
Right, it's 195 feet, so it was long range. So he missed.
Okay.
And then next up is Havoc.
All right, I'm going to move forward 35 feet.
So that's 50 feet.
Wait, hold on. Yeah, I counted too many squares. Undo that. Hold on. Okay, so there.
Okay.
And still long range, but I'm going to shoot at water.
Okay.
So I don't have to put disadvantage on it. It'll figure it out.
It should. I will fix it if it doesn't.
Okay.
That should have been disadvantage, though, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, so I guess I don't know why I did it for the NPC and not you, but roll one more time. Oh, well, you missed anyway.
Yeah, I missed.
Okay, so that's fine.
And that's it, my turn.
Okay. So then next up is Noel Elephantine. I don't know what that's supposed to mean.
He's going to move straight forward 25 feet, which would be, you know, 30 feet technically since he's moving through me.
Oh, wait. Okay, hold on. Well, he can go around you and get 5 more feet if you want.
Okay, that works out
I think he can. Let's find out.
Well, no, because he's got to do 2 diagonals.
Yeah, okay, so it ends up being the same.
Mm-hmm. So, okay. Yeah. And he will also use a longbow on Havoc.
Okay. So...
I could drop the attacks on them.
Yeah, I'm just trying to see the distance. Is it short range?
Oh, no. No, I don't think so. Is it?
I don't know. I somehow all of a sudden I can't get a target on. Hold on.
145 feet.
Oh, 145. Yeah, I can see Havoc's target to that, but now I can't do the reverse. So,
then it would hit. It wouldn't do the disadvantage.
So it is short range though, because it's 150-600. So that's fine. Mm-hmm. So that's a hit. Okay, so that's a hit. So you can do the damage. So Havoc takes 6 damage. And then that's that guy's turn. And then Foolish Caught Red-Handed is next.
He's going to move in 30 feet closer to get these guys in front of me.
So he wants to kind of do the same thing up like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
And is his range to Havoc 150?
Well, if the other one was 145, then his is 150, yeah.
Okay, then he will also be attacking Havoc.
Am I mistaken that you seem to be quite enjoying this, Fury? A little bit. That is a hit.
Didn't you see when she was sitting there all giddy like a kid waiting for presents?
Yeah. Oh, 8 more damage.
He likes having minions.
Havoc's hurting.
I do like having minions.
Okay, so then that's that guy's turn. And now it's actually Water's turn. By the way, you are not bardically inspired by Galarin anymore.
I didn't think I would be anyway at this point. I'm hurt, so I'm just going to do Cure Wounds on myself.
Oh my god, this is... Oh. All right, we need to...
What?
Well, the entire party should have gotten long rested at the beginning of this.
Well...
So...
Those of us who have their maximum hit points don't like that idea.
Well, you get back all your spell slots and all that other stuff, too. So,
I'm the only one with spell slots.
Havoc has been hit twice. Havoc has been hit twice. Who has anybody else been hit?
Well, water was hit, had damage before we started.
No. Right, but.
But I've been hit since the combat.
I made as a DM, I fucked up totally, and the entire party should have been long rested before we started this battle, and I just forgot to do that. So Havoc should have all, you know, he's...
Well, were you hurt before, Havoc?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it was.
How much?
A lot. He's only got 1 hit point right now. So, here's what I need to do. I need to individually... So, just, I'll fix it. Just let me fix it. Let me...
Well, I mean, at some level, if you just long rest everybody...
No, because that's gonna fuck up the initiatives. So,
well, you redo initiative at every turn anyway.
No,
right?
I know. Mark, just let me DM. All right, and sure. I'll fix it. Okay, all right, we're good to go. So now, basically the only thing that changed was Havoc got all his hit points back. All you guys got all your spells or whatever you get for your class when you long rest. And then Havoc has 12 damage from his two hits that happened during this battle.
So, what about the damage on water?
Oh, how much was that?
20,000.
Did she get hit?
Yeah, yeah, I hit her with the longbow. Or shortbow, rather.
Oh, yeah, then she has... How much was that?
6 points of damage.
So everybody got hit with six all the time.
No, because Havoc got hit with an eight and six, so he would have 14 points of damage.
It was 14. Okay, that's where the eight was. Okay, so I think we're good now. Havoc has 14. Water has six. Garland... I didn't make it! I didn't make it. Gowron has no damage. Okay, so Fury, you can continue.
Okay. Well, then that changes what I was going to do. I'm going to just do this little step right there. And... Okay, this is going to be at a disadvantage because it's my crossbow.
Which is like 120-300 or something like that, right? Or 80-320?
Yeah, 80-320.
Okay.
What? How? Why did that not do it automatically?
We decided that's not a thing.
That the disadvantage thing wasn't working automatically?
No, it's not automatic. I don't. Okay. So when I first rolled it for an NPC, it did work, but I don't know why. I could have actually had disadvantage marked and just didn't really realize it.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that's a hit. Either or, yeah, they're gonna hit. Sorry. And then she's just gonna finish her movement right behind her minion.
Okay.
Sorry, not sorry, Havoc.
All right, so round two. Nappy shock. The party is outmatched, by the way, just so you know. It's supposed to be.
Is it supposed to? You know, I'm not going to ask. I'm just going to let it happen. I'm just going to let it happen.
So what? How come? I have one that's... Interesting. I found an error in Fantasy Grounds. It's not identifying. Anyway, so three more gnolls show up back there. And it is... Foolish Caught Red-Handed's turn.
He's going to go ahead and move up 30 feet, close the distance, and longbow Galrin.
Okay.
So move him up 30 feet.
That's a hit. And does some damage to Galrin. Oh, I guess I have to pass. Yeah. By the way, Fury, what I told you about the gnolls was off because of the number of players. I overestimated, so.
Okay, if you want to get rid of some, that's fine.
Yeah, already done.
Okay.
All right, Galrin, it is your turn.
Move there.
Hide behind the wounded guy.
And cast Cure Wounds.
Yes! Wounded guy.
Hey, for some reason, Rob, whatever you did, it just deleted that NPC thing you gave me.
Oh, my bad. Got it?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay. Okay. Water's turn. Havoc was healed.
Okay. All right, she is going to move up 20 feet. She's going to use her crossbow at a disadvantage at Havoc.
That's a hit. Disadvantage. Havoc is on the ground. You know what? I'm gonna alter this further, Fury, because it is way. It's supposed to be difficult, but it's not supposed to be like overwhelmingly overpowered.
All right. So, do you want to get rid of the
yeah,
last
I'm
three that you just
the
added?
The other three that are
okay.
That are because that are there. I somehow miscalculated that. I'm used to playing this with four players, and I forgot we were doing it with three, and you got to way scale it down. Okay, so here we go. Let me just get rid of these nappy.
Yeah, they haven't gone at all. So.
Yeah, they haven't even taken a turn, so. Oh, yeah, that's the guy that's not identified. Bitch. All right, so Elephantine is up.
All right, do me a favor. Give me Elephantine's sheet because you got
I
rid of...
I took a
yeah,
away.
You keep killing my thing. Okay, so Elephantine is going to move 25 feet, and he will be a little bit in front of me.
Okay.
He can be a little bit more in front of me.
So go 30, okay.
Yep. All right, he's going to use his longbow and attack Gowron, since Gowron's still standing.
All right. That is a miss.
Okay.
Small Legs is next.
He is going to move a full 30 feet. Okay. And he will also use a longbow to attack Gowron.
That's a hit. Seven damage on Gowron. Havoc has a death success roll, and by the way, if you guys Havoc, especially if you want to use your inspiration on a death roll before it happens, just let me know. Noel Small Legs is next.
He's gonna move up 30 feet. Longbow attack on Gowron.
It's a hit. For some damage. And Havoc, do you want to use your inspiration on your death roll or no?
No, right, not yet. I okay. Got one success, okay. Right?
Yeah, you do. And now you have one and now you're one and one. Elephantine.
Move up 30 feet. Longbow on Gowron.
Oh my god, another hit. Another
small
damage.
Small damage.
All right, Gowron.
All right, I'm going to do some janky shit.
Janky.
So.
Are you going to use Havoc's dead body as a shield?
He's not dead.
Maybe. No. So, drinking a potion is an action. Therefore, I can cast a bonus action cantrip, right? Or a spell.
Absolutely.
Right. So I am going to drink a healing potion as
okay.
My action. Then I'm going to cast bonus action healing word on Havoc.
Okay. Okay, so Havoc is conscious and prone, and you are better healed. And Noel, foolish Noel, foolish, caught red-handed, foolish Noel, foolish.
He will go up 30 feet. And still attacking Galarin because, you know, we just see him up.
Right. That's a hit. Oh my god. Max damage. And sadly, it is Water's turn. This is very overpowered, as it should be.
All right, she's going to move up a full 30 feet. Oh god, still so far away from these boys. She's going to take the negative two minus penalty from shooting behind her minion.
Okay.
At Galarin.
That's fine.
So, negative two disadvantage.
Yeah.
Well, but no, you've got to shoot through Havoc also.
No, because Havoc is on the ground.
Oh, all right.
You're standing up.
Get up, Havoc, damn you.
Get up.
Told you, man. Meat shield.
That is a hit. Oh my god, now Galarin is on the ground. All right. Small Legs is up, and they, even though they're not marked, both targets are now prone. So
right.
Their would have disadvantage.
Right, but we're not going to do that.
Okay.
Because I don't know that they're both. I don't know that Havoc's conscious. I'm not there to check his pulse. So he will do movement and then action dash.
Okay, so he wants to go 60 feet.
Yeah, 60 feet. We got to check the bodies.
All right, check the bodies. 60 feet. Okay. And then, Havoc, you are conscious and prone.
Okay, so I saw Galarin fall, right?
You did.
You could probably feel it right behind you.
I'm going to use my bonus action to cast Healing Word on him.
Okay.
And then I'm going to use my action to turn into a direwolf.
Are you going to stand up first?
Well, you don't have to.
No.
No.
You don't have to.
No. I'm okay. Going to just change first.
Go for it. All right, so you change into a dire wolf.
Then I'll stand up.
Okay.
And I'm going to eat that one.
You got a 50-foot movement, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's it. You got action, bonus action, movement. So you're done.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Elephantine is next.
Okay. He's going to move up just a little bit, 15, 20 feet.
Okay.
And we're going to longbow at the big wolf now.
Okay. That is a hit. And Foolish Game is next. Foolish Game.
He is going to move up a full 30 feet and also longbow Havoc.
Okay. That is a hit. Wolf not liking it. And now Water herself.
She's just going to move right there. She is going to use her crossbow, not at a disadvantage, mm-hmm. not at a minus mm-hmm. two.
I see what you're saying. That's a, oh Jesus, that's a hit. All right.
And then she's just going to kind of, step back in line.
All right. Galarin is prone and is ready to go.
Stand up. Cast cure wounds on myself.
All right.
Move up there to get some blocked by a wolf.
Okay. All right. Next up is Small Legs.
He is going to drop his longbow and pull out his spear.
Okay. And he will only be able to use that one-handed for reasons.
Okay.
I love you, man.
Yeah, DM David Keith. Thank you for the resub. Bit boss. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead. How do you do? How do you?
It says bite, but it's actually going to be with a spear because it says range attack plus 4 to hit. It's still plus 4 to hit regardless.
Oh, yeah. Hold on a second.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Melee or ranged. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. You're fine.
Okay. So,
that's a hit.
Drop the damage. All right, Havoc. You have a chance to retaliate against my very healthy gnoll.
It is Havoc's turn.
All right. So, I'm going to attack the gnoll. Can't target the gnoll.
Yep, you got him. Small Legs.
That is
Oh no, it's not Small Legs. He's not my favorite. It's fine. He can die.
Wait, Havoc, 1 second before you do anything. Okay.
All right, so I can put the prone effect on him?
Yep.
And then I'm just going to do damage.
All right, he's fucked up.
And then as my bonus action, I'm going to cast the combat heal, a wild shape heal on me.
Yes. Nice. All right, very good.
He's down on the ground, right?
The gnoll, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, you knocked him prone, yeah.
Did he lose his weapon?
Why would he lose his weapon?
Usually, if you get knocked prone, anything in your hand falls out. So I'm asking because I'm going to dash
past
him.
In all my years of D&D, that's the first I've ever heard of that. If you go prone, you lose your weapon. I've never heard of that. Is that a thing?
It's something I do to my players, yeah.
Oh, no. That doesn't happen in my games. I mean, I've never heard of that. Nobody's even ever mentioned that to me in my entire life. And the prone condition I'm reading here doesn't say anything about losing your weapon. So, no, the answer is no. Just because you're a dick to your players doesn't mean I have to be a dick to my players.
And even if he did lose his weapon, he does have a bite attack and he would bite you or attempt to bite you.
That's true.
As you run past.
That's fine.
Which
I'm going to go to there.
Oh, okay. So,
off
attack.
Small Legs, yeah.
Yeah, make sure if you're not using Small Legs, so just
he's using the spear.
Just mark disadvantage because he's prone.
I don't know if that's going to work for me, though.
Oh, okay.
You might have to do
ahead.
It.
Yeah, go ahead and do it.
Let me try.
Well, okay, wait. Okay.
Oh, nope, it did. It worked.
No, it didn't because I had disadvantage marked, so we don't know if it worked or not.
Okay, well.
What? He hit anyway? What the fuck? I don't like it.
I do.
Yeah, I know you do. Okay. Now he's all up in your business.
That's fine. I can kill him.
All right. Anything else for Havoc?
No, that's it.
Okay, Galren would be next.
Gonna move there.
These guys know who to go for.
Gonna shoot a short bow at water.
Okay. That's a hit. Yikes. 10 damage.
Wait, hold on. I would do my reaction shield.
Too late. You didn't say it fast enough.
What?
You didn't give me a chance.
What does the reaction shield do?
Throws up shield. So it added another 5 AC.
Oh, so he's... Okay, yeah. Okay, so... it's still a hit.
Well, hold on. I didn't even put the effect on it.
Oh.
I'll try.
Oh, so now it's a miss. Okay. So we will undo the damage. Is it shift? I never fucking know how to do... Is it shift? It's definitely not shift. Hold on. Okay, I'll fix it manually. Go ahead. That's fine.
Bonus action, combat inspiration on Havoc.
Okay. Nice. Elephantine.
Okay, he is going to drop his longbow and pick up his spear.
Okay.
He's going to be attacking the direwolf.
That is a miss.
Damn.
Havoc, you saw that combat inspiration, right?
Yeah, I saw it.
So, water is next. Oh, you're not unconscious. Wait a minute.
Thanks.
Thanks.
I'm going to do... She's going to use a dagger and do a catapult.
Catapult? What the hell is that?
With the dagger, yeah. It's that spell.
Oh, yeah, okay.
It's either hit or miss. Oh, wait, hold on. No, you got that fucking thing, don't you? Can I use inspiration on that?
Is it an
no,
attack?
No, because it's a save. It's a save.
It's a save, yeah. He, however, right. can use inspiration on his save if he wants to do
I
that.
I know.
But,
you know what,
but Havoc, do you want to do that before she does it?
So what's she doing with the catapult? Like she's throwing the dagger on the ground?
Yeah, I'm just like having it here in my hand and just like it. It's just going to go
flying
itself.
Can't be carried.
Is that what it says? Oh, I can drop it. Drop it for reaction and then cast a spell.
All right, so... yeah, I'll use the inspiration to dodge.
Okay, so mark advantage on your thing, and then she'll do the thing.
Ready?
Good. I don't know if it's gonna work, but go ahead.
I don't know if it's gonna work either.
We'll
try.
We'll re-roll it if it doesn't work. Okay, so re-roll the save.
What is it? A dex save?
Yeah. So you passed.
Okay.
Damn it.
She burned a spell. And a turn, basically. Look at that big green check mark on that wall right there. Okay, foolish game.
He is going to focus on Galren with the longbow.
Okay. That is a miss.
Ouch.
So, Havoc is next.
All right, so I'm going to attack water. Let me take off the note. And what does the combat thing do again?
That gives you an extra d6 on your attack, I think.
Attack or saving throw or weapon damage or your AC.
Weapon damage, is that right?
Yeah.
Yep.
That's whoa. Okay.
Alright, so I think I'm going to use it for the attack.
Well, you get to decide after, right?
Oh, okay.
So that's a hit.
So then I'll put it on the damage.
Okay, so...
What do you have advantage for, though?
Combat inspiration.
Oh, is that what that is? Okay.
No, the advantage, sorry. That's not advantage.
Right, I was about to say, I'm like, why is he getting advantage?
He's getting advantage probably because he has pack tactics and you're next to him.
Oh, yeah.
So,
oh.
I don't know what it is.
You dropped a 9, but it doesn't say...
It doesn't say which one's first.
Yeah, so just roll a d20. Okay, so 13 plus 5 is an 18. Does that hit water?
Yes.
Okay. So then you can now roll a d6. Just roll any d6. I mean, and then put a 2 in your modifier box when you do damage.
Okay.
And that'll be the combat inspiration die added to the damage.
I'm also going to do the... I'm going to do her strength DC check.
Oh, right. She succeeded. So that was 4 plus 1 plus 3 plus 2. Okay. Yep. Okay. Still alive.
And then as my bonus action, I'm going to heal myself again.
Okay. What the fuck? Okay, anything else?
Nope, that's my turn.
Okay, water.
Okay, I'm gonna do poison spray on him.
He fails. He take 4 poison. Galren.
Gonna cast Dissonant Whispers on water.
Here we go. She succeeds.
I think I take half damage, don't I? Isn't that a level 1 spell?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I think it's half.
Mm-hmm.
All right, she's still alive. Noel, Foolish Game. I call him Foolish Game. It's not his name.
Okay.
Look at all the blood. Just look at it. That's a miss.
Okay, next.
Next is... yeah, just give me my next guy. Next!
Okay.
Elephantine. Spear attack is a miss.
Damn it. Okay.
Next guy, small legs, bleeding out over there.
He is standing up. He is using the spear. It does have an extra 5-foot reach. He is using it two-handed. Fuck.
Fumble!
He has an extra reach. What are you talking about?
Yeah, it has a 5-foot reach.
Oh.
Or does he have to be next to him?
No, I thought 5-foot reach is adjacent. Yeah, you would not have been able to.
Oh, okay. He would move next to him. Okay. Fine.
Gotcha. There. All right, he fumbled. All right, Elephantine gets to go again. Look at these guys.
Great.
And that is a hit. So you're only supposed to be using that one-handed.
Why not? Why can't I use it two-handed?
I said that. I already said that.
He was using it two-handed.
Say that again?
I said he switched to using it two-handed.
Yeah, and the only reason I didn't say anything is you already made the attack roll and missed, so I decided to just not say anything. But initially I said these guys only attack one-handed, and you said okay.
So said for this first time. I didn't
no,
know.
I did not
split.
Mean that. I meant that it's too overpowered, Fear. You can't be using a D8.
Okay.
So
Then just heal him back, and I will roll with the other one.
I'll just give him 2 points back.
No. I'll re-roll it. Just heal him.
Okay, hold on. Who is it? Havoc?
Mm-hmm.
See? You already DM'ing already. Heal him. I'll re-roll it. Go ahead. Okay. Okay, foolish game.
Options. He can't hit worth shit. Very disappointing, foolish.
Oh, by the way, these guys have a shield, is why I made that rule.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay, so then Galren gets to go.
All right, second level, Dissonant Whispers on water.
You got to target her first. Failure.
Didn't even do the extra die.
What extra die?
Second level spell.
Oh, you forgot to.
You can. It won't matter because she's unconscious. But you gotta. If you do the second level spell, you gotta do the. You gotta right click the die before.
I tried it. Just did the thing, okay. But whatever.
All right. So now. She is unconscious, but not dead. So. Oh, sorry. Galren, did you want to do anything else?
No.
Okay. So, Havoc, what are you going to do?
Two on the knoll.
So, she's unconscious?
She's unconscious. She's lying on the ground, not dead.
So, yeah, we'll fight the knoll then.
Okay. That's a hit. Okay, damage done.
And I'm gonna throw another combat heal on myself.
Okay.
Okay.
Another one. Oh my god. Okay, don't pass your turn quite yet. Water, do you want to use your inspiration for...
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead and mark advantage. And then Havoc, you can pass your turn. Why the fuck... Okay, roll a d20. Well, but not two.
Oh, fuck.
Just roll another one.
Well, it dropped an 11 as well. So even if it was 11.
Yeah, okay. So then you, that's a, so then that is a,
save.
That's a success rather than a, right, exactly. Okay, you marked it. Good enough. Okay, so then, small legs.
Attacking with this, attempting with a spear. Finally.
It is a hit. Galren takes 4 damage. Havoc is up again.
Alright, so the one I'm on, I'm going to attack him again.
Okay.
I might need another character sheet, null sheet, if he kills this one.
Oh, if he kills it, I just won't remove it.
Okay, cool.
Now... Shouldn't that have been at... Isn't he prone?
No, he didn't fall down.
No, he didn't.
He did. Okay, my bad. Okay, so that's a miss because he didn't fall down.
Right. But I am going to stay right there.
Now I wish I had those extra gnolls.
Everything's going to be fine, no matter what. Galren.
Thunderwave on the dude next to me. I'm not going to draw it. Cause...
Nice. I like it. Thunderwave. Guaranteed damage. Fails. He's not dead. So he gets pushed 10 feet, though.
Yeah.
Okay. And anything else?
Yeah, I'm going to move there.
I like it. Water has rolled another success. No foolish game, I call him. He's not. That's not his name. Somehow undamaged, this Noel.
He's been staying back.
He shoots his bow. And that is a hit against Galarin for some damage. And small legs.
He's going to get up as close to Galarin as he can.
Okay, 10, 20, 35. So he dashes to there.
No. He can stay 30, and he's going to throw the spear.
Oh, well, that's not what you said, though. You said I want to get as close as I can.
Oh, sorry. I said close with his movement so he can still attack.
He's going to throw the spear. Okay.
He is.
And that's a hit. And Galarin is unconscious.
Good.
Who knows what's happening now with all these.
I love you, man.
Okay, you gotta move on to the next guy.
Yeah, I know. I'm still trying to... So, there's no... Out of all the fucking tokens, there's no spear? You gotta be shitting me.
Just put down a sword or something.
Oh, wait. Here's a spear. Whoa!
It's a very all right, big. It's all blood covered and everything.
Let's never mind that. Let's just forget about that spear. Oh, my God. Now I really screwed this up. Now, how do I... Oh, enjoy the spear artwork, everybody. It stays. Okay, so then... Elephantine is up. Enjoy the spear.
Melee with the spear.
Oh, maybe that's a. Oh yeah, it's here. It's a. I can get rid of it like that.
I can't hit him. Okay, it's fine. Wait. It's fine. It's fine.
Okay.
There you go. End of turn.
Using my inspiration on my death save.
Okay. Elephantine is next.
Here again.
Oh my god. This is bad.
For them, not for me.
Havoc didn't die. He didn't die. Alright. So this is going to be here. Let me mark advantage and see if that works for your death save here. Oh, it did. Okay, good. So. Mark that off, and you got a success, and foolish game. Who's going to win? Who's going to win? That's a miss. So Havoc gets another turn. two of you guys are unconscious. This is amazing.
At least kill water.
This is horrible.
I balanced it about right, though. It was...
Hey, I didn't try to murder you guys once you were unconscious. I tried to be nice. And I even pretended like I didn't know you were conscious when you were healing each other.
Well, you played the Anyways. Gnolls. You played the Gnolls as they would have played, so that's good.
And myself.
Yeah. All right.
Anyways,
so
go ahead.
Have it do something.
Yeah, I'm going to attack the one that I've been attacking and try to get him to stop hitting me.
He misses a lot, so I know.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God. Okay.
Last second level spell was a bonus action.
Okay.
That's my turn.
All right, Noel, small legs.
Okay, I need to draw this out so you can see what I'm doing. He is going to move. He is going to pick up the bow and go to that square there. He's going to pick up the bow that's behind Elphatine, right? That's doable. That's a free action.
Yes.
So he can shoot the bow at Havoc.
Okay.
I just wanted to make sure.
Miss.
And miss, still.
Okay, so water gets another success.
Is that my third one? I think that's my third one. That is my third one.
Yeah, you are stable and unconscious. Havoc gets to go. Look at your little heart.
Thinking about changing to a bear, but I will continue to attack elephant team, whatever.
Oh, that's a little cheater way to get more hit points. Just change forms. Haha, Jesus. Oh, okay, let's mark the date, everybody. This is December 17th, 2021. This is a hit.
And are you going to kill?
He fails, and...
He's prone.
He's prone, but he's probably going to die.
And
yeah, he's
dead.
Okay, he's
dead. So sad.
It's very sad. Okay, anything else for Havoc?
Can't cast a spell on Galarin until these things are dead or I change form. And if I change form, I got one hit point left. So I'm just going to move over here.
Okay. By the way, we're not taking a break because this is the last thing. So we don't need to take a break because it will only be another few minutes. Foolish Game. Once again, not his name. That's just what I call him. That's a hit.
Why is he getting disadvantage?
Because you're shooting with a... You're engaged?
No, Foolish Game is over here. He's someone that's healthy and not hit.
Oh, shooting at...
Is that because... The attack is already dead.
Yeah, that's why. So I need... I mean, granted, it's still a hit, but... Yeah, I need Foolish Game and the other... Small...
Because you're using the stat. I see. Here, let me give you Foolish Game.
And Small Legs.
And Small Legs. You dropped a 16, though, so it would have been a hit anyway.
Yeah.
So you can do the damage. Okay.
Cool.
And then Galren is about to death fail. Boo. Oh, now. Galren, you must have passed your turn, didn't you?
I didn't do anything.
Oh, you didn't do anything. Okay, never mind. I'm freaking out because... Oh, now I can get rid of this guy because you've got all the stat blocks. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, so it is Water's turn. She did what? Oh, you're stable.
Nothing. Yeah, I'm stable.
Okay, Small Legs. This is interesting. Who's going to wake up first?
I think I'm just going to go ahead and do this as a disadvantage. Okay. Yeah, as a disadvantage with the longbow.
Okay. That is a miss. And Small Legs...
Hold on! I was going to see if I can get Small Legs to run away.
Oh, do you want to run away? Go ahead.
Yeah, except he's going to go northwest as far as he can, 30 feet.
Well, I will take an opportunity to attack before.
Yeah, go for it.
Go for it.
All right, I missed him.
Okay, and then it is Small Legs' turn again.
Great. He is going to move back another 30 feet. Damn. Okay.
Didn't help.
Didn't help.
All right, Havoc.
All right, so I am going to move to this one over here, and on my way there, I'm going to change into a bear.
Okay.
Wait, can he? Can he go into?
I don't know the Druid rules on. I don't know the rules on one form to another. I don't know if you have to unshift and reshift, or if you can just shift. I just don't know the rule. We should probably find that out.
I'll read it. Okay. Yeah, let's make sure.
So let's see, how do you, let's see.
Does anyone in chat know?
Oh, Diablo Bob says you can direct shift per rules.
Oh, okay.
So I trust him, so let's say he can do that. Yep.
Bob, you're not helping me right now.
So my question, though, is this. Should I undo the change from the wolf and then do the bear, or will it go straight from one to the other?
No, I would say undo and redo.
Okay.
So yeah, Bob is saying in the chat, FG mechanically unshift and reshift.
I hate you right now, Havoc.
You started this mess.
I did not. Rob pulled me aside and says,
it's your fault.
Be the big
it's
bad.
Your fault, for sure. 100%.
And he nerfed me. He took away all my other extra gnolls.
Well, I thought you were going to. It did not look good initially. It looked like these guys were going to die in round two.
And now it's looking bad for me. Real bad. I don't like losing.
But it doesn't ultimately matter. You'll see.
All right. So I can't, because it takes an action to do the shift, I'm just going to be in front of this thing.
Okay.
Growling menacingly.
I growl back.
So actually, sure. We're going to make this easy by putting Skip Turn on water because she
That's fine.
Is stable.
I'm stable. I'm a stable person.
Galarin had a death success.
You're a stable genius.
And it is now going to be Havoc's turn.
Okay, so now I get two attacks.
And the bear can run faster than the gnoll, so this is going to be interesting. Oh.
Stomp water on the way by when you go after the gnoll.
I will. All right, so first attack is going to be
Don't be sad because you're dead too, Mark.
I'm taking you with
That's
me.
That's a hit. Don't be sad because you're dead. All right.
Attack is a bite.
All right.
And then I'm going to run after the other gnoll, stomping on water one time as I run by.
Well, you won't have, unless the bear has an extra stomp attack.
No, it's just a joke, Rob.
Oh, okay, because I thought you would want to try to kill her.
No, she's still our friend, isn't she?
I don't know, is she?
She's not going to murder you.
I'll come back. Oh, wait, I can go 40 feet. Sorry, so I'm going to go an extra 10. Okay. An extra 5. Because that was 35.
Okay.
You're a little gnoll. No, I'm done there.
Gnoll Small Legs.
He's going to run 30 feet west.
Okay. That's a hit.
7.
All right. Galren is stable. Galren is a stable genius.
He gets skip turn 2.
And now he gets to get skip turn. That's right. Oh my god, the errors that are popping up in this goddamn... Alright, so, Noel. It's between the Noel and the bear, everybody.
He's gonna move 30 feet southwest. I don't know, yeah, because, yeah, southwest.
That's a hit.
Oh, wait. No, it's the same thing. Wait, no, it's not. I didn't mean to do a spear. I meant to do a longbow. If it was an 18, would that still hit?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, and Havoc.
I'm just going to double move until I catch him.
No.
Good call. All right. Havoc is first.
God, no!
All right, so targeting the bear, no thing.
I hope you fumble. I hope you fumble twice.
That is a hit.
I hate you.
All right, as that happens... You all find yourself wide awake and fully healthy, and you hear the voice say, one day soon, I will see you again. And then again, the maniacal laugh off into the off into the distance. And you then all find yourselves fully healthy, fully friends.
Love.
No, you just go to third level. And the white fades into an unfamiliar landscape, and you feel something on your chest just below the neck. You have the mark of the eye, the new tattoo. You discover the new and unrecognizable world. What adventures await? Who was that villain? What new hell has been unleashed? What world is this? All that is known is that there is the unknown whom. The end. Yay! So now, here's a little preview. Here's a little... Let me get this. I'm not used to the new. I don't know how to use the sidebar thing yet. Okay, here we go. So. What? You can't even search for shit in here? Oh my god, what a pain in the ass. Let me open this up, and then I will. Show a thing. So that's the mark you got on the back of your neck. So that's the tattoo you guys got. And then this is the cover for the next adventure that Furied will run in February.
We can't even see that the tattoos are there. They're just there.
You feel the burn in your neck, and you get this mark. You get this mark.
Okay.
And then I will play water, and she will DM, and that is a level 3-6 adventure. It goes fast, though. It doesn't. I can't remember, Furied, when we played it in Whistler, how many sessions it was, or how many hours it was.
I think it was like 2 or 3 days, 3 sessions.
Yeah, and maybe like it wasn't we did longer sessions though. We did like 4 or 6 hour sessions,
true.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it might be about as long as this one was, probably. Four sessions or between 4 and 6 sessions probably. And then Mark will McClancy will DM his adventure after that, yet to be determined. So for Friday nights, we are done until February 18th. Wednesday, Saturday, and Sunday still have a few more sessions, a few more games to play. I mean,
wow.
a few more streams is what I meant to say. I'm trying to make this picture bigger. Here we go. So, and Furied Fate had a hand in writing The Unknown Whom Part 2 with myself and Leroon and the guy who's a restaurant manager in Canada. I forget that guy's name. Well, it's in the credits. I should be able to know that.
Did he write anything or did he do map stuff? I know there was like somebody that did maps.
No, the writers were me, you, Farid, and Leroon. And then cartographers were Marbania and Dreadhand.
It was a big project.
And then it was a big project. And we finished it in October of 18, I believe. Rob Tui urges adventurers to remember that all eye colors are dangerous. Whomever you meet in your travels, don't trust anyone with eyes. You cannot see past their souls. That's right. All right. So I apologize for the anticlimactic ending. Although it was pretty close. It got down to where everybody was unconscious. So that's pretty awesome.
At least once or twice.
Yeah. So what I'll do is I'll zip up this campaign. I'll long rest all the characters and zip up the campaign and send it to you, Fury, so that all you have to do is open the campaign and you'll have everything ready.
Okay.
And then if you have questions and you know, we have a lot of time. Plenty of questions.
I actually need to read the whole module
Let me give everybody their XP while we long rest. You're not going to go to
level 4. I know they're all going to be level 4 already.
No, it shouldn't be that though.
Oh no, but it does say so. They have enough XP for level 4.
Oh, do they?
Mm-hmm. Because when you did the long rest before we started the encounter, it says, hey, you're now level 4. I'm like, oh, cool.
Interesting.
So.
I screwed this whole adventure up, by the way.
You didn't scale it for 3.
I hadn't DM'd anything in literally like 4 years, and I fucking screwed this up because you guys got way more XP than you were supposed to get. And, you know, not that that's bad for you guys, but I did it wrong. So here, where's the party sheet?
You can just say it was a milestone to level 3. And just wipe everybody's
XP.
Well,
no, you guys only have... So here. Yeah, you guys have 1855. So if that extension told you in the chat that you have enough for level 4, that was just an error. Because you guys all have 1855 and level 4 is 2700. So you're about halfway there.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's right. Okay, here, let me long rest everybody. Okay, so everybody's long rested. Everybody's got all their hit dice, all their hit points, all their everything. You're level 3, so you'll start at level 3, or we will start, because I'll be playing Water. I'm going to officially change Water's name to just Water.
Is Chad coming back?
Chad will be back. Oh, I got to put Chad in the...
Can you un-unconscious us and remove this?
Yeah, I'm going to do that.
Turn.
So that when Fury gets the campaign from me, it should all be good. Now, Chad was what?
A defender, a bulldog, a metal bulldog, a construct, an NPC.
Here. Chad is actually, still in there. Okay. Okay, I think this is good. I think this is all set. So good. Any questions, anybody? I think I had fun doing it. I didn't do as good a job as I should have done, so I apologize for that, but hopefully you guys did have fun. And
It was good.
When Fury gets nervous about DMing, we can just refer back to how bad I fucked this up, and then you guys shall be fine. It'll be great. But to the players, I want to officially say have a good holiday, Christmas, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, whatever it is you celebrate. I hope you enjoy yourselves with your families. Again, family, don't understand the concept. Don't understand what any of that means, but I know you guys all have families. And then we'll be back February 18th for this stream. And if that's it, then I'll bid you adieu. See you guys. Take care.
See ya.
Hi, everyone.
All right. So there you go, everybody. We played the D's and the D's and all the other D's. Now, here's the thing. Here's the thing, C. Once again, the Friday show will be done until February 18th, but we will still be doing the Wednesday show for another week. We will be doing the Saturday and Sunday shows for at least another week. Basically, the stream, there's no streams from January 1st to February 13th, but there also won't be one on Christmas, which is why, and Christmas Eve, right? Which is why, because people do family shit. That's why a week from today would be Christmas Eve, so that's why there's no show that day. Oh my god, the integrated module unload from the loaded list. They put that in Core RPG. That's awesome. I don't know what any of that means. My brain is fried right now. So disappointed in the job I did on DMing that, but it is what it is. All right, so actually I'm going to take that unknown whom out of the rotation. I don't even know how to do that. Game slides, here we go. Properties. Wait, what? Where? Oh, I see. Here we go. Okay. Wow, that's unknown whom, delete, like that. Okay. So yes, we'll make it on Wednesday, and then tomorrow should be, yep, we're doing that tomorrow, Lost Mine of Phandelver, and then that'll be the last one, and then Sunday we're doing a show, but we will be doing one on the 26th as well, so we'll do two more of those. All right, everybody, I think that's it. Oh, end of stream rewards. Let me do it. Like that. And then also, I will tell you the things that you can do to support the channel if you so choose to do that. These aren't things that you have to do, but that you can do if you'd like to. And they are. Just type any of those words, exclamation point, Discord, exclamation point, Patreon, exclamation point, sure, whatever you want to do. Discord will, of course, take you to our Discord server where we have 2,200 people talking about Fantasy Grounds and DM's Guild and D&D 5e 24/7 worldwide. And Patreon will take you to my Patreon page where you can kick in to support me if you'd like, as little as $1 per month. You can Chibits, subscribe or resubscribe to the channel, and if you do that during the show, you will attack the bit boss, which is currently McClancy 10,006 at 1625. He had 12,000, but he only has 1625 now. And then you can also go to DM's Guild and purchase items. I beg you to do so. Sales have been dog shit on DM's Guild. Like, literally sold like four things yesterday. And, you know, you sell like a few dozen or 100 things in a day. And then one day comes up and, you know, maybe it's Christmas time and everybody's out of money. I don't know what it is. December hasn't usually been traditionally bad. But yeah, today only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 things have been sold today. So that's just very low. Very, very low. You can also subscribe to the YouTube channel. That's free. You don't have to pay anything for that. We've got over 1,200 videos. So you can follow me on Twitter or check out the Facebook page. And don't forget, on Twitter, on Facebook, on my Patreon, on my Discord, everywhere that I have an opportunity to say things, I will put we did a bunch of quarter sales. I did like 4 quarter sales where you could buy a module on the DM's Guild for a quarter. And so you don't know about that unless you're following all my socials. Actually, I'll put in the chat right now. Is it Linktree? How does that work? Let me just put it in there. I forget the name of the thing. Oh, here. It's timed messages. Oh, is it? I thought I had one, everybody. Maybe I don't. Maybe I don't have a... Wow, do I not have a thing for Linktree? I could have swore I did. Well, here, I'll just put the actual URL. So if you go to linktr.ee, linktree/Rob2e, that'll give you the opportunity to know like literally every place you can find me or everything you can sign up for or do. That even includes an email list, which I rarely use, but if you're on it, you would find nuggets in it. But there you go, everybody. That's it. So I think we're done. So for Friday viewers only, happy holidays, and we'll see you back here. Cheer bits! Drake takes. Hey, Drake popped in. What's up, Drake? Diablo Bob, if you open the library window and list on the left of the loaded modules, I had added the unload option from that right-click menu. They added that feature into core. Oh, wow. Here, let me put this back for a second. So if you open the module window and go to the library list on the left of the loaded modules, the list on the left. So you're talking about here, right? Here's the list of modules. Okay. You mean just that I can unload a module? Yeah. That's cool, I guess. But I like to be able to unload all of them or, I see what you're saying. Do that. Yeah. Oh, so when I send Fury this campaign, I also have to send her the zip up all the extensions I'm using. FGU doesn't like unload all. Boo. Someone's tweeting. Let's see. Probably. Someone was just asking, so if you happen to be at the end of the stream, you're going to know this thing. Someone just asked me, am I doing the Insanity Bundle for Christmas? And I am going to do it, only I'm not going to advertise it. I'm just going to turn it on. I might advertise it. I might put it, say on Twitter, but I'm not doing a big buildup like I did for Thanksgiving, like tweeting every day for 4 weeks. I'm just going to turn it on and... Yeah, well, not true, Drake, because there will be a Sunday show on the 26th. You might not be there, but I am doing it on the 26th, the day after Christmas. But this is the last Friday, tomorrow's the last Saturday, and this coming Wednesday is the last Wednesday until forever, until next year. But Sunday has two more shows. Yeah, so I am going to turn on the Insanity bundles probably Christmas Eve and leave them on till New Year's Day or something like that. But I'm not going to it's only going to be for people that notice it, like, "Hey, there's a bundle, let me get it." But I'll probably I mean I'm stupid if I don't say it. But, you know, I'll tweet it or put it on Facebook or tell Discord, but I'm just not going to do like 1,000 tweets like I did for the Thanksgiving one, because that was just such a pain in the ass. And so, yeah. All right. So what now, everybody? Is that it? Do I close Fantasy Grounds? Do I? Oh, I'm going to release. Yeah, I'm going to release. I'm going to release. Okay, I'm going to tell you right now. Is everybody ready? I'm going to tell you right now. I'm going to release this character. I'm going to clear owner on water so that I can claim ownership when I sign on, when she does it. That's how you do it. All right, so then I'm going to close that. So, yeah, this should be good. I should be able to close this Fantasy Grounds, and I should be able to zip up that campaign and send it to her. Boom. All right, who else? Anything else, guys? Is that it? Is it over? I think it's over. Today is Friday. Oh, they're bringing my arcade machine at 10:30 tonight. I can't forget that. I just got to stick around for that. Oh, a polyp, let me get in. I don't like it. All right, arcade machine arrives at 10:30 tonight. Pinball machine sometime in the next 2 weeks. I got the video today. I got the video of the pinball machine today and some pictures. All right, I think that's it. I'm out. I'm out. I'm out. I'm out, you guys. I don't know what else to say. Good gaming, everyone.